name is Francesca, and today we will be going over melodies using the first three strings and along with their notation. So the first melody that we will be going over that you may or may not know is Hot Cross Buns. So it is in 4/4 time, and I will count us off. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Exercises that you may be practicing and doing, I recommend maybe clapping them and trying it out, or also you can count as you play, but for this video specifically, I'm not going to be counting as I play, but if that is something that is helpful to you, I highly recommend that you do it at home while you're practicing. So the next melody that I will be going through is Happy Birthday. So as you can tell, these may be melodies that you know already or have heard around or like nursery rhymes, and they are fun pieces to play as well. So Happy Birthday is in 3/4 and it has a dotted rhythm in it as well. So I will be counting one bar of nothing and then the rests into the beginning. So 1, 2, 3, 1. And then I recommend that you also finger these melodies and write in the notation what fingering works best for you. In past videos, I've gone over what fingerings that I most commonly use and that are easiest for the most part. And if you want to go ahead and write those in, that is a good habit to start so that when you're playing longer pieces or more complex pieces that you maybe aren't as familiar with, then it becomes easier to understand what your left hand fingering or even right hand fingering, like what both of those hands should be doing. So the next melody that I will be going over is Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. So it is in 4/4 and I will count us off. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So also feel free to go back through any of these melodies or even just the ones that I've played thus far, and you can play them at different tempos and different rhythmic values so you become more and more comfortable with these pieces. So the next piece that I'll be going through is Ode to Joy. So it is in 4/4 and it will count us off. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then the next piece that I will be playing is Old MacDonald, and it is in 3/4 as well, so I will be counting this off. 1, 2, 3, 4. Thank you. And then the next piece that I will be playing is Mary Had a Little Lamb. So it starts on the open E string, and we will go from there. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Since Christmas time is coming up, it will be Jingle Bells. So it is in 4/4 and starting on the E string, open E. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Today and practice them over and over again and play them in your free time too, because they are quite fun. And it is great that we've incorporated the learning of the notations on the first three strings and how to play those notes as well. So I hope you guys learned something new, and thanks.
Let's talk about arpeggios. What are arpeggios? Arpeggios are a way to play chords. Now, we've been learning a little bit about chords each week here. And an arpeggio is when we take one of those chords and we break it up and play all the notes sequentially. Now, you can play these from low to high in what we would call ascending. You can play them from high to low in what we would call descending, or you can do a mix of the two. Now, typically when we do arpeggios, we have a fixed right hand position on the guitar strings, and we are going to be plucking each finger using free stroke. All right, so let me give you a brief example of an ascending arpeggio. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my thumb, put it on the low E string. And why don't you try this with me? I'm then going to take I, M, and A, and I'm going to place them on the top three strings. Now, I'm going to do what's going to be called a P, I, M, A arpeggio. And we're going to be calling it that because that is the order in which I am using my fingers. So it would be P, I, M, A. All right. So let's do that again. P, I, M, A. Now, after I play that arpeggio, you'll notice that my hand is kind of curled up. I don't have any pinky sticking out. I don't have anything like that. My hand is nice and relaxed. And I'm doing everything from the bass knuckles, right? So remember, that's where all the power comes from in our hand. So when we're plucking, we want to make sure we're moving from here and not, you know, doing something like that. So let's now do a descending arpeggio. Let's put our P, I, M, and A back on the same strings, but this time I'm going to do an A, M, I, P arpeggio. So I'm going to be doing descending from high to low. A, M, I, P. I'll do that again. Thank you. And now let's do a mixture of the two. I'm going to do a PMIA arpeggio. So that would sound something like this. Right? So I'm going to go PMIA. PMIA. So now let's apply one of the chords that we've learned previously to these arpeggio patterns. So I'm going to choose E minor. We're going to take our second finger and we are going to put it on the second fret of our D string. I'm going to take my P, I, M, and A, and I'm going to place them on the appropriate strings. So my thumb here, my P, is on the D string. My I finger is on the G. My M finger is on the B, and my A finger is on the high E. Now, my right hand is in this fixed position. My left hand is in this fixed position. Now, if I wanted, I could pluck. But we're gonna do an arpeggio. So we're gonna do a PIMA arpeggio. And we're gonna go through it like this. PIMA. And you can hear we let everything ring. And at the very end of the arpeggio, it sounds like what the plucked chord sounds like. All the notes of the arpeggio kind of blend together and we get this final chordal sound, right? So that's one of the really cool and unique things about arpeggios, is it's another way to approach these chords. So let's try and do this together. Ready? So get your left hand set up, get your right hand set up, and I'll count us in. Ready? So we'll do one pluck on a beat, so we'll go one, two, ready, go. P-I-M-A. Let's try that one more time. One, two, ready, go. P-I-M-A. So there are many different ways to approach chords now. We know how to pluck, strum, and do arpeggios.
Hey everybody, I'm John Story. I'm a guitar player and guitar teacher in Los Angeles, California. And let's talk more about strumming patterns today. In particular, strumming patterns which include the strong beat, which we learned about in the other video, beats 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then the off beats, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And as we've learned from other videos, the strumming pattern that's our strong beat is when we're strumming down, so 1, 2, 3, 4. And then the off beats, the ands, are where the hand is coming back up. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So what happens if we're doing a strumming pattern where the strum carries over from one strong beat to another strong beat and then plays the and of the next strong beat? If we were to write this out, it would be 1, 2, 3, 4. What would that sound like? And how would we strum that? 1, 2, 3, 4. That would sound like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. So I'm keeping my arm going the whole time. This pattern, we're gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4. My arm is gonna move through all those beats just like I would be playing the beats. 1, 2, 3, 4. But I'm gonna go 1, 2. So the ghost strum in this case is happening on the strong beat of 2, and right after that, I'm gonna hit the strings coming up. 1, 2. Watch that again. two, and. One, two, and. Could you tell how I was ghost strumming beat two? One, two, and. One, two, and. It's interesting because people who aren't guitar players may not notice that our arm is moving, yet we're not making a sound on that second beat. It just looks like we're just moving our hand the whole time. Because as Ryan described in the other video, our hand is like a clock or a motor. It's something that just keeps moving. We want to keep that pendulum moving when we're strumming because that gives us really strong beats. So let's practice one, two, and three, four, and one. Two and three, four. One, two and three, four and one, two and three, four and one, two and three, four and one, two and three, four. Let's just listen. And I'm playing my E chord, by the way. I'm gonna maybe switch chords here in a bit. I'm gonna go to G chord or C chord, but for now, let's stick with the E chord. Listen to me. One, two, here I go. Might seem easy for some of you, but for others, it's a little hard. It's kind of like learning dancing. We can learn the moves to dance to a song, but to really get the dance, we have to actually be feeling the beat. And we have to kind of know what's going on with that beat. In the case of us guitarists, a big job of us when we're playing chords, whether we're accompanying ourselves singing or accompanying someone else or just playing chords for fun, we need to be syncopating the beat and keeping the beat really steady. We're kind of like a drummer in that sense. You ever watched how a drummer in the right hand and the left hand, everything is really loose and it's always representative of where the beat is in the music? Well, guitar players are really similar to that. Our right hand is this motor, and just like a drummer's hand is going to syncopate those beats. So let's try another couple strumming patterns. The classic one that we hear on most songs is one, two, and three, and four. One, two, and three, and four. So we're playing a strum on beats one, beats two, and for three, we're gonna cross over the strings, and then we're gonna go and four. So we kind of have a tie in the middle of this measure. One, two, and three, and four. I'd say guitar lesson 101, if we're going to learn a strumming pattern that we hear on most songs, it's going to sound like this one. Sometimes I teach my students down, down, up, up, down, 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 up, up, down. Some students can do well with the down, down, up, but some people struggle with that because they haven't figured out the concept of the ghost strums yet, so we want to attach numbers to it. One, two, and three, and four. One, two, and three, and four. Beat three is the ghosted strum. Let's do that again a little slower. One, two, ready, go. One, two, and three, and four. One, two, and three, and four. And it's hard because we're thinking about our hand moving up and down, but if we keep the arm just moving like a motor, or like Ryan said, a clock, it shouldn't be too much of a problem. One, two, and three, and four. One, two, and three, and four. So now that we've got that pattern down, and we're practicing that with our teacher and our other classmates, how about together we practice that strumming pattern, the one, two, and three, and four pattern, or down, down, up, up, down. And let's go around some chords with that. Let's do the G chord, the C chord, and the D chord. These are all coming right out of our caged chords that we've been learning. One, two, and ready, and go. One, two, and three, and four, G. Let's switch to C. D. Back to G. So that's the strongest, most common popular strumming pattern that we're going to play on guitar. A little faster, you might recognize it. One, two, three, four. It's E minor. Here's another question that's commonly asked at this point. What kind of pick are you using? Well, I've got my classic favorite Fender 351. It's a medium pick, and it's the pick that I described in How to Use a Guitar Pick as being kind of our most common guitar pick. I bet many of you in class, if you have a guitar pick and look at the pick your neighbor is using, it's either the pick you've got or the pick that they've got, because it's the most common guitar pick you're going to find anywhere. So we've got our down, down, up, up, down. And then we've also got one, two, and three, four, and one, two, and three, and four. A couple different kinds of syncopations. I'm going to improvise some of these. Take a listen to how the strumming pattern changes, but my hand continues to move like this. So it's always a combination of ghost notes, ghost chords, ghost strums, and strong chords. Great job today. Again, working on our dotted eighth, dotted quarter subdivision patterns with strumming and working on strong, combining strong beats and up beats in our strumming pattern while keeping our hand going nice and steady. If you got questions, ask your teacher or drop us a line here at GFA. Again, I'm John Story. Thanks for joining me today for our class. See ya.